Well, good morning, everybody. And my name is Jordi, Bartolomé, and I'm going to speak a little bit about music21 and new applications to score following and feature extraction. Well, first of all, music21 is a project developed at the MIT, in which the Michael Cuthbert, that is not here today, what is the lead of the project. First of all, let me do a brief introduction. You know that during the last years, there has been a revolution in all related to computer and music. Computers changed the way that we acquire music and we share music. Now you can download or buy a song just clicking a button. And it also changed how, for example, how composers change their way to notate their scores. You can do it now using computers. Or, for example, there are lots of programs that analyze sound, like the first stuff that we listened today. For example, you can detect which song is playing a musician just and using your iPhone or an application. So there are many applications related to analyzing the sound and the music. But what about scores? There are no application, or there's not an important change to the application to analyze the scores. So, for this reason, music21 was created or developed. music21 is a software that, it's a toolkit for helping people to answer questions and simply and quickly about music and analyzing the scores. Because, for example, have you ever asked what is the most repeated note in a song? Well, maybe not, but you could take a song and then count the notes and say, okay, this one is the most repeated. Okay, but what if I say, what is the most repeated note by Schumann or some composer? Well, the answer is not that fast. Or for example, this one was the first band to use some chords in some order. Well, this is, you can get these answers just programming one or two lines of code with music21, because it analyzes all the scores that you want and get the solution very fast. This program also has another part that is to compose. And it allows you to compose songs. There are lots of programs now that composers can use to improve, but what if you want to do a song, you want to write a song taking a part from a Bach song, another one from a Mozart song? Well, you can do it opening these songs with music21 and taking the part that you want and mixing them and then creating the final score with no more than 10 lines of code. This is, let me show you an example of what is the most repeated note, for example, by Schumann, Chopin. Well, this is only an example. Of course, the most important thing is that now, having this information, you can analyze the behavior of these composers or whatever. But what? How does it work? How music21 works? It analyzes songs in common musical formats, and then lets you use this data and program using this data and then get all what you want. Like the example that I said before, or whatever. The format that music21 supports are, well, the most common. There are more than this one, but these are the most common, like music XML, ABC, MIDI, of course. And then what you can do is to get songs with this format, then convert this format into music21 format, do whatever you want with the data, and then if you want, and convert back the song, the song into the previous format. And then if you want to show it, you can do it very fast using finales, values, whatever. But, well, what can we do with music21? What are the applications that we can create using this program? For example, if we can use data, we could generate, for example, we could create an automatic generator of counterpoint. We can create a program, few rules, few harmonic and counterpoint rules, set a length from the score, and the computer will generate a good score without mistakes. And this could be, for example, used by students or whatever.
For the composition homeworks.
Or for example, why not? We could create a Braille notation later. If we have a song that we want to convert into Braille, we can get this song and analyze the data and then get the notes, the sharps, flats, whatever, the rhythm, and then just using some definitions, you can say this note is, well, this character, I don't know. These two applications are in the music21 library if you're interested in. And well, the application that I'm gonna talk today with is the score follower orchestra. We wanted to create a software that shows you in the screen a score and then slides the pages automatically, and then you don't have to do anything manually. You can just play the song from the beginning until the end. So this was the idea. How does it work? Well, of course, the computer has to detect the sound, has to show you the scores, and mix them, and
so to be clear, it works with audio, not just with a MIDI enabled instrument.
No, sorry, no, okay. With audio, this is the challenge, because with MIDI, that's easy. Okay, so how it works, okay. We need scores, microphone, and a computer. But we wanted to do as general as possible, and we didn't want to use expensive hardware or microphones. So we decided to use only a laptop, worse than this one. So with a network, with a notebook it works. And we use the microphone of this laptop, and it records the music, not only from a violin, whatever you want. And then it shows you the screen and the text, the beat, well, the text where which note you're playing.
Monophone.
Yes. This is and this is using only a monophonic songs because well, it has to detect the fundamental properties of the signal, and you can do that with polyphonic. But yeah, this is one of the problems of this software. First, let me start with the score. We need the score. We need to show the score in the screen, but we also have to analyze this score because we need to know what are the notes inside this, of course, the rhythm of the length of the notes, whatever. So we need to use as many scores as possible. So we decided to scan these scores, and then we used an OMR system. There are OMR software that converts the image of a word into a digital word. But we use an OMR system that recognizes the notes and then converts these notes into music21 notes. So we can use all the songs. We just have to scan them, these songs, and use the software, and then we get the data of the notes and the rhythm of the notes and the number of notes. This one part. The other one is the audio signal that, well, we are using the microphone of a laptop, so the quality is very low, and we have the raw data of the audio, so we have to process this signal. In order to do that, we used, in this case, the autoregression function, that it works very fast. We have to take into account. The idea is that we want to record during few seconds the sound, then we process the sound, record again during six seconds, and the sound, record and process the sound again, and to the end of the song. So we have to process this sound very fast because we haven't had the computer running half a minute processing the sound, because you can finish the song and then it doesn't make sense. So we use in this case a autoregression function to find the fundamental frequency of the signal, And with the fundamental frequency of the signal, we can get the pitches of the sound and also the rhythm and the length of the notes. With this, we can estimate which note is playing the position and the, well, and the length of each note. This is an example. This is an example, for example, of the audio processing. This is at the end. We have processed the audio, we have here the frequencies, and then we have to decide when each note starts, or if this is a La or a Si or whatever. And knowing the duration of each frequency, we can estimate that this is a quarter note, for example, or a 16th note, or whatever. With this, we have the last step, that is the matching. Well, we have to take into account different things. The first one is that we are using an OMR recognition, so it introduces some noise, so the extraction of the notes is not perfect. We are processing the audio using the microphone of our laptop, so the audio is not good, and then we have to match the notes that we have from the score and the rhythm, and the notes that we have from the audio and the rhythm, and then predict which one is the part of the song that you're playing. This would be an example. And this software divides the song in many different parts, and then it calculates which one are the most similar to the score. Sorry, to the audio signal. And finally, depending on the last prediction, because if the last prediction is here, it doesn't make sense that the next one is here, no? So last prediction and the probability of every part of the score, you decide which one is the one that you have been playing. And then, automatically, when it considers that this is the best moment, it slides the pages. Let me show you an example of this. This is the software. I was playing the piano. Sorry for the performance because I'm not a pianist. But it's only a 20 seconds video. And you will see that I'm playing this song. And when the software considers that it's necessary, it is detecting the position every time. And when it thinks that it's the best moment, it slides the pages.
So when does it slide the page?
When?
Hopefully when you're past the separation, right?
Yes, that's the first. And when I'm in this page, and depending, it's like the page, depending on the position of the detection, because it takes some seconds to detect the position. And if, for example, I'm in this part, it slides the pages and slowly, slowly. But if the detection is here, the speed of the sliding is faster, because you have to read the next page. But yes, it does it in the second page.
Oh, we need to do the audio again. We're going to get a little bit of feedback. You know, can you play your speakers loud? I think it's going to work better for this one because it's such a feedback loop.
Mm-hmm. Are you plugged in?
No.
That's okay.
We're getting such a feedback loop on this.
Good.
Now we use the melody of the violins, and when we can detect the measure of the playing. And, well, that's all. Thank you very much.